Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the Philippines. Hope you guys are doing all right. Praise God. I love all you guys, as you know that. I know many of you guys who love me. Of course, when we're a Christian, you know, Jesus said that, you know, servant is above his master. You know, they hated me, they hate you also. So there are people. We always have people that... you know, especially if you try to do YouTube videos, since it's a social media, you always will have people, you know, who are big and bold behind their laptop. You know, like they wouldn't come into the church and start shouting at the preacher, "Oh, I don't believe in the pre-tribulation rapture." They probably wouldn't do that. It's pretty rare. But to get behind their computer in their house, they become bold. So that's, you know, I guess a phenomenon, a phenomena of social media. That, you know, we have this whole different thing that you deal with, which is good and bad, where you have, you know, the discussion and comments and, you know, Facebook comments. And brothers and sisters, I would say that 90% it's a good thing. I know lots of people are discouraged by it. And, you know, I try to keep my comments on my videos pretty cleared out. Because, not for me as much as lots of you guys who are viewers, it's upsetting when people are attacking, calling names and things like that. And so I remove it so that other people won't be drawn into it. You know, that's the whole thing. When you see those comments, it, you know, it tries to, the devil is using those, his little minions, to try to draw you into the flesh, to get into the flesh with them. And... you know, I remember when I first got into the ministry and I was trying to evangelize my family and my relatives. My brothers are atheists, militant atheists. And, well, the ultimate, just like most people, they like to party and carry on and mock God and all these things, like some people, other people. And, of course, as a new believer and as a new... I got saved when I was 8 years old, but I was a backslider from the time I was a teenager until the time I answered the call in the year 2000. So I was a backslider for sure, but never denied the Lord. I'll put it that way. I always believed in the Lord since I got saved when I was 8 years old, and but it was just living in sin. Anyhow, and lots of people are like that. Very common, brothers and sisters. The vast majority of people, when they become teenagers, you know, they walk away from the Lord. And then by the grace of God, you know, that they would come back when they, you know, grew up, matured, and got over that bad stage of being rebellious and all that as a young adult. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I used to be so upset and just fighting mad, trying to deal with my relatives and stuff. And a lot of you guys who comment to me, that's what we talk about, you know, dealing with your evil relatives and stuff. But no one can save anybody. Only the Lord can save people. You can't save anybody. I can't save anybody. You know, and that's why we have to do like the... And, you know, when I've been saying this before when I was in the Philippines. I didn't know, but now that I've been in the States, I saw now. So I guess the Lord was really kind of leading me on that as kind of an accidental prophetic joke. I've been using the saying of the song "The Gambler" by Kenny Rogers was my guiding rule as being a pastor. You know, you got to know when to hold them, know when to fold them, know when to walk away, know when to run. And I've been saying that. I didn't know. When I went back to the States, I saw, wow, they've got this Geico commercial with Kenny Rogers, you know, and it's so annoying him singing that song, you know, why he's gambling with his buddies. But it's really true. It's just a simple way of looking at it. When you're dealing with people in the comment section, you know, some people have more patience than others. I observe, especially there's some sisters who've been Christians for many years who do a pretty good job in not getting upset and getting drawn into the flesh and arguing and all this with some commenters. Some younger people and newer believers, it's easy to get caught up in this, you know, you get in the flesh. I mean, next thing you know, you're going to be cussing somebody out. Because they're, you know, the evilness in them, you know, is drawing, you know, that's what the devil wants to draw you into that. So if you can't stomach it, just don't even look at the comments. And I've never mentioned that in a video. I should have. I always want to ask people who are getting so upset about comments. Don't read it. I mean, just don't look at them. It reminds me when I used to be a medic and I worked in the emergency room for 4 years and we would have people come in, you know, because, most of the patients you deal with in the Army are young people. There's some retirees, but most of the retirees are not that old either, too much. But, your active duty people in their 20s, probably the average person is 20, whatever, 21, 22, 23. And they come in and they've hurt their leg from the Army. You have to do all this running and all this kind of stuff. So maybe they pulled a muscle in their leg, and they just give them some Motrin and they get light duty for a week or whatever. But they'll come in there and they'll say stuff like, every time I stand on my right leg, just like take my weight and put it on my right leg, it'll start hurting. And then I've heard many Army doctors say, well, stop standing on your right leg and it won't hurt. I mean, it is true. It's common sense. If I put all my weight on my right leg and it hurts, stop doing it. That's the short answer, right? Of course, everything's more complicated than that. But it's the point that if people are upsetting us or are bothering us, the best thing to do is just walk away, and let the Lord send someone else to deal with that person, if we're assigned to deal with that person, then we won't be getting all tore up about it. We'll be able to, handle it in the spirit of the Lord, by the fruit of the Spirit. So we just pass it off to somebody. So that's what I would just mention in this video as an advice video from the Lord. Don't bite off more than you can chew. If you feel like the Lord is leading you to deal with people in the comment sections of videos, like my videos or anybody's videos, to try to minister to them like several of you do, that's great. Because, the thing about like myself, I mean, if someone gets on there and says, oh, the rapture's a big lie, and I comment back to them and, I go through and explain and all this, well, in the same amount of time, I can make a video that 1,000 people can see, and then put it out there as opposed to sitting there typing. But lots of you, you don't make videos, or you only make a few videos. And your skill is more at one-on-one talking with the comments. Well, that's great. The Lord would use you in that area. That's awesome. I invite you guys who are serious Christians and mature Christians to deal with people who come on saying, well, I needed to be saved. I'm afraid I'm not going to go in the rapture. Or is the pre-tribulation rapture real? Whatever their question is. I'm grateful and thankful to those of you who deal with them in a mature, loving way. And I appreciate that because, I can't deal with everybody in every situation. It's just, just like anybody, my time is just so much. And that's all I can do. I get tired, and I don't want to be, before I would try, always try to answer everybody. But if you don't give someone the time they deserve, then it can be a negative thing. If you just give them a quick, short answer when really you need to spend a long time chatting with them, and so that's why I thank the Lord for you guys who would do that. God bless you guys. The Lord has dumped so much stuff on me. I got so many videos to make. Praise God. So I'm going to cut this off and just call this, I don't know. I'm just laughing because there are people who really get tore up about comments. On their channels and then on other people's channels. And I understand, but like I say, by the grace of God, I just learned to just, if I have to block them, ignore them, whatever, I just can't, I just can't. Because the enemy, like I said, when you go back to the Kenny Rogers, the philosophy of that I'm using here, you can't help all the people. You can only help some of the people some of the time. You can't help all the people all the time. Is a famous saying, and as I mentioned this before, it's like when I was as a paramedic, you do triage, which is sorting and an order of priority. So there's some people who are like if you're in a war zone, like when I was in the Army, we did lots of training. And I was actually in the Iraq War. When you're there, usually the person screaming for the most help needs the least help, but. The people who are not screaming are the ones that are really hurting the most. If you had 10 people to help and you see one person that is going to die no matter what you do, you don't help that person. It depends. That's why you have to have discernment from the Lord. This person is an atheist who's on your channel or on my channel, and they're just mocking and clowning, and then, you know, you can't help them. They're not there to be helped. They're there to distract, to kill, steal, and destroy, and hurt, and damage the gospel, and damage other people's chance of getting saved. That's what they're there for. So you have to quickly, you know, pray and ask God for discernment and wisdom in dealing with that person. So, you know, you can go to their channel, and if you, you know, and look at their, you know, look at the discussion on their channel, see what they've been saying on other people's channels. You can see, maybe they've been all over the internet, you know, mocking the Lord and attacking people. Maybe they're only a teenager, you don't know. Sometimes they're a teenager and you can help them. So that's why you got to see what they like on their channel. And then I've seen, as an example, you see people that have, you know, came on my video when I talked about the grace of God, and I'm not a greasy gracer, as you guys who watch my videos know. They'll come on there when I made a video about grace, because you can't mention every topic in every video, and they'll say, oh, you got to follow the law and all this. And, you know, you got to walk in holiness, you can't go to heaven. And then I'll go to their channel and see that all their likes is worldly music videos with half-naked girls and video games. And I see all those video games and say, well, they're probably a teenager. And I read all, and I look at what, you know, because you can look on somebody's channel and see what they've been liking. And then you see all this worldly stuff, and then they're coming on, you know, my channel. Here I am, a preacher. Here I am, a missionary. And some guy's going to come on my channel talking about holiness, and then all their likes and favorite videos is like nearly porno, basically, of music videos and all this kind of stuff. So you know that someone is just absolutely insane, out of their mind. They're a hypocrite. Now, that's a hypocrite. This is the kind of people that you deal with. So you have to use all these different strategies, and I don't know why I'm talking about this topic, but, you know, you have to discern either by the Spirit of the Lord or looking at their channel. Use wisdom. Listen to the words they use. If they're a teenager, like I say, the younger they are, of course, we give them more grace. We're more open to say that, oh, this person is just, you know, is immature. But, you know, when you get someone that's, say, over 30, 40, 50 years old, and then they're on there with all this crazy stuff, you know, the Bible says, you know, your heart becomes more hard. The older you get, you know, their heart becomes seared with a hot iron, the King James says. They become callously going to that reprobate mind. A whole lot harder to deal with than a younger person. So you have to discern all those things, brothers and sisters. But like I say, the bottom line is, if it's getting you angry and getting you in the flesh, then walk away. Walk away. Don't let them bring you down in the flesh with them. If you can't bring them up, just walk away. I mean, that's all you can do. Pray about it. Give it to the Lord. Ask someone else. You know, you can send a private message to me or someone else. Say, hey, can you try to talk to this person? Whatever. Just like in the medical field also, that, you know, the Hippocratic Oath is, you know, to do no harm. So, you know, when we're working and do ministry work, you know, we don't want to do any harm. Sometimes we can't help people, but we don't want to make the matter worse. And when we get in the flesh and start arguing with them, we ended up making the matter worse. You know, it's just like a doctor who's mistreating you. And if they just left you alone, then you were left alone. And then when they come in and give you the wrong medicine, and end up killing you or whatever. So, you know, we don't want to do any harm. No more harm than what the person has already got. So we have to figure out whether we can help them or walk away, run. You know, give it to the Lord, brothers and sisters. Anyway, God bless you guys. I've got lots of cool videos to make as the Lord will lead me. Since it's Sunday morning in the States, here it's Sunday night here in the Philippines. That's my, you know, my pastoral advice, brothers and sisters. God bless every one of you. I'll be back. I shall return. You know, who said that? Since I'm in the Philippines, General MacArthur said that right here.